Hi guys, a very happy welcome to our channel, and this is Srinivas. As a part of already mentioned complete arithmetic series, today with this video we are going to start that series with ratio and proportion. Ratio and proportion is a very basic concept in arithmetic, but it is going to be used everywhere in the arithmetic. No matter which chapter you are dealing with, ratio and proportion will appear there. So don't neglect any concept. Let me make you aware my way of teaching. I am going to make you clarity on concept and then properties. After you are very comfortable with the concept and the properties of the subject we are dealing with, then application of concept and properties to the given problems to solve them in a very advanced and easy methods. Once you get the grip on the concept and properties of the chapters, we can easily solve the questions without any hesitation. So first of all, let me teach you what is ratio and proportion. What is ratio? Ratio is nothing but establishing a comparison between two similar things. The comparison between two similar things. Two similar things. The comparison between two similar things is nothing but ratio. So what we can conclude now? Ratio is between two similar things only, not between two unsimilar things. We can make a ratio between the weights of two persons, namely female and male, but we cannot compare female with male. That means we cannot establish a ratio between female and male, because female and male are not similar things. But we can establish a relation or ratio between the weights of female and male. Why? Weight is a uniform unit for both the female and male. To indicate ratio, we use this sign, this two dot sign, the sign in the brackets. And it is called as is to. A is to B. This is the general form of the ratio. And it is read as A is to B. This sign is indicating the ratio between those two, comparison between those two. And it is read as A is to B. Here A is the antecedent or precedent, and B is consequent. In general terms, we call them as a first term and second term, but in conceptual wise it is antecedent or precedent. A is antecedent or precedent and B is consequent. First of all, start with the very basic questions and then go up to the very high level. That is the best way to learn any subject, starting with very basic concepts and then go to the very high level up to what we are required. Here we discussed only about the ratio. About the proportion and the proportion properties, we are going to discuss in the next video. First of all, get a clarity on the ratio and its properties. Divide 400 in the ratio of 2 is to 3 is to 5 and find each part. This is a very basic question. We need to divide 400 in the given ratio of 2 is to 3 is to 5 and we need to find each part. Okay. Here 2 is to 3 is to 5. Two similar things are involved in the ratio. And summation of those three similar things is nothing but 400. If we take the terms of the ratio 2, 3 and 5, we know the summation of those three. Let me get the summation of 2 plus 3 plus 5, that is nothing but 10. 2 plus 3 plus 5 is 10. But here in the problem, the actual value of summation of those three values is nothing but 400. 10 becomes 400. The value what we are assumed is 10, but the actual value is 400. 10 becomes 400, that means the unit of one value is 40, or the value what we assumed is multiply with 40 times to get the original value. Now we can say the each part of the ratio. First part, that is 2. 2 units, the value of 2 units would be 40 times of the 2. 40 times of the 2, that would be 80. Second part, that is 3. Second part is indicated by 3. The actual value of 3 would be 40 times of 3. Multiplying every term of the given ratio with 40 gives us the correct answers. 3 into 40, that is 120. To get the final part, that is 5, multiply that 5 with 40, that gives us 200. Now the each part of the given ratio after distributing 80, 120 and 200. Very simple question. Let's move to the another one. Here we have A is to B is 2 is to 3. B is to C is 4 is to 5. Find A is to B is to C. A is to B is given by 2 is to 3. B is to C is given by 4 is to 5. We need to find A is to B is to C. This is the very basic concept, but we are going to use it everywhere. Combination of ratios. Combining or merging these two ratios into one ratio of A is to B is to C. Method 1. Let me make you aware of this. Method 1. In this method, to get A is to B is to C, just write the A is to B as given, that is 2 is to 3. B is to C as given, that is 4 is to 5. 4 is to 5. We need to find A is to B is to C. You need to find A is to B is to C. We need to find A is to B is to C. To get the A is to B is to C, first of all, multiply these two. Multiply these two. 2 with 8, 4. That gives us 8. We got A. And then B. First term is A. We got 8 as A. Then we need to find B. To get B, A, B, A, B. This 2 is to 3 is representing A and B. To get B, multiply this 3 with 4. That gives us 12. And then multiply 3 with 55, that gives us 15. A is to B is to C is 8 is to 12 is to 15. That is what we required. 8 is to 12 is to 15. And method 2. In the method 2, just make the ends of those two ratios equal. In the first ratio, we know A is to B as 2 is to 3. And in the second ratio, we know B is to C. B is to C as 4 is to 5. 4 is to 5. Here, B is involving 2 times here and here. If we make B equal in both the cases, then we can join that ratio easily. B is 4 here and B is 3 here. To make B equal in everywhere, multiply this ratio with this 4 and multiply this ratio with this 3. Then A and B will be 4 times of the 2, 8 is to 12, and B is to C would be 12 is to 15, 12 is to 15. Now we can conclude A is to B is to C as A is representing 8, 8 is to B is 12 in both the cases, so B is 12 and C is representing 15, that is 15. A is to B is to C would be 8 is to 12 is to 15. This is the method 2. And there are a lot of methods to do these type of questions. But these two will be helpful in for us in saving the time. First method will be solve in very few seconds. Very few seconds. A is to B is given. B is to C is given. We need to find A is to B is to C. Just rewrite those two. 2 is to 3 and 4 is to 5. To get A, multiply these two. 2 with 4, that is 8. To get B, multiply 3 with 4, that is 12. And to get C, multiply 3 with 5, that is 15. Very easy. We can solve in 3 to 4 seconds, that is 8 is to 12 is to 15. 8 is to 12 is to 15 would be our answer. That is option A. 8 is to 12 is to 15. And the next one. A is to B is 2 is to 3. B is to C is 4 is to 1. C is to D is 2 is to 5. Find A is to B is to C is to D. Same question, but three ratios are given and we need to merge all those three ratios to get the final ratio of A is to B is to C is to D. First of all, let me write the A is to B. We don't need to write A is to B, B is to C, and C is to D like this. After we have clarity with the concept, we can write those values only 2 is to 3, 4 is to 1, 2 is to 5. But to make you aware of the concept in a beginning way, we are in just a beginning way. So, no problem with writing A is to B. A is to B is 2 is to 3. B is to C is 4 is to 1. And C is to D is given by 2 is to 5. 2 is to 5. We need to find A is to B is to C is to D. We need to find A is to B is to C is to D. To find A is to B is to C is to D, first of all, multiply all these three to get A. 2 with 4 and then with 2. That is 16. Then to get B, multiply these 3 with 4 and then continue towards this line. 3 first 12, 12 2 is 24. B is 24. To get C, multiply 3, 1 and then with 2. This is the way. Continue 3 multiplying up to 1 and then multiply with 2. 3 ones and 2, that is 6. To get D, multiply all these things. 3, 1 and 5, that is 15. That is 15. So, R required A is to B is to C is to D would be 16 is to 24 is to 6 is to 15. Where is that? Option C. 16 is to 24 is to 6 is to 15 would be our answer. Let me explain you once again. Let me explain you once again. Please be aware of this. 2 is to 3, 4 is to 1, 2 is to 5. These are the three ratios we are given. Multiply these three to get the first one. These three to get the first one. That is 16. Multiplication of 2 with 4 and then with 2. To get the second term, multiply 3 with 4 and then continue downwards. 3 first 12, 12 2 is 24. To get the third term, multiply 3 with 1 and then with 2. And then with 2. 3 ones are 3 and 2s are 6. To get the final one, multiply all these 3 towards downwards. 3 ones are 3 and 5s, so that is 15. 16 is to 24 is to 6 is to 15. Or I have discussed you another way, that is method 2. That is nothing but making ends equal. Making the ends equal. Here B is 3 and here B is 4. To make those B equal, we need to multiply this ratio with 4 and this ratio with 3. This ratio with 4, this ratio with 3. Then when we got A is to B is to C. That is 8 is to 12 is to 12. 8 is to 12 is to 3. 8 is to 12 is to 3. Here, when multiply with 4, it becomes 8 and 12. Multiplying with 3 results 12 is to 1. A is 8, B is 12, B is 12 in both the cases, and C is 3. Then we need to find D. Here, C is 3, here C is 2. But we need to make those 3, those 2 C's into equal 1. To get that, multiply this ratio with 2, that means the first term of this ratio, and multiply this ratio with 3, that is the last term of this ratio, with 3. 8 2s are 16, 12 2s are 24, 3 2s are 6, and we don't need to write C here, we already mentioned C. So go with the D, 5 3s are 15. A is to B is to C is to D would be 16 is to 24 is to 6 is to 15. That is what we required. That is option C. These two are the very best methods and very easy methods to measure these type of ratios. And then A is to B is 2 is to 1, B is to C is 3 is to 2, C is to D is 3 is to 4, D is to E is 5 is to 2. Find A is to B is to C is to D is to E. Same type of question, merging the ratios. We are not going to write A is to B, B is to C, C is to D, or like that. We have acclimatized to that. So just write the values, given values. 2 is to 1, 3 is to 2, 3 is to 4, and then 5 is to 2. Now what we required is A is to B is to C is to D is to E. That is nothing but You get the A, multiply all these, 2 3s are 6, 6 3s are 18, 18 5s are 90. To get B, multiply this 1 with 3 and then go downwards. 3 1s are 3, 3 3s are 9, 9 5s are 45. To get C, multiply 1 with 2 and then with cross 3 and downwards 5. 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6, 6 5s are 30. To get D, multiply 1 with 2 and 4, then with 5, that is 40. And to get the last term, that is E, multiply all these terms downwards, 2 2s are 4, 8, 8 2s are 16. So the required A is to B is to C is to D is to E would be 90 is to 45 is to 30 is to 40 is to 16. We have find out what we require A is to B is to C is to D is to E in a very simple manner. Where is that? Option C. 90 is to 45 is to 30 is to 40 is to 16 would be our answer. Next question. If A plus B by C is C by 5, 6 by 5 and B plus C by A is 9 by 2, then what is the value of A plus C by B? First of all, be aware of here, A plus B by C and B plus C by A. Two ratios are given. But if you observe here, in both the cases, A, B, C, all these three terms are involved. A, B, C. Here, B plus C by A is given. Here, A plus B by C is given. But in both the ratios, all the three variables are involving. A, B, C, all three are involving. So, the summation of those two values should be equal. Why? When all these three things are involving, when we get the summation of A, B, C, that should be equal. Here 6 and 5, 6 plus 5 is 11, here 9 plus 2 is 11, 9 plus 2 is 11. So, we don't have a problem here, we can take the values directly from the given ratios. When the summation of the all the three variables is equal, we don't have a problem and we can take directly the values of the required variables. A plus B by C is 6 by 5. Here A plus B is indicating 6 and C is indicating 5. So we can conclude that C, the value of C is 5. B plus C by A is 9 by 2. B plus C is representing 9 and A is representing 2. So we can conclude that A is 2. But when we sum the all the three variables, A plus B plus C is 11. A plus B plus C is 11. When C is 5 and A is 2, B would be 4. A plus B plus C is 11, C is 5, A is 2 and B would be 4. What we need to find A plus C by B? We need to find out A plus C by B. A is 5 and A is 2 and C is 5, that is 7 by B, that is 4. A plus C by B is nothing but 7 by 4. Where is that? Option D, 7 by 4 would be our answer. A plus C by B is 7 by 4. If A is to B plus C is 1 is to 3 and C is to A plus B is 5 is to 7, then find B is to A plus C. Same type of question. But observe here, A, B, C, all the three variables are involving in the ratio and C, A, B, all three are involving in the ratio. So, the summation of those two ratios should be equal. When three variables are involving, the summation should be equal. Here the summation is 4. And here the summation is 12. These are not equal. So, first of all, we need to make them equal. Here, the summation of A plus B plus C is 4. Here, the summation of A plus B plus C is 12. Make both the sums equal. To get that equal, we need to find out that 4 with 3. We need to multiply that 4 with 3. Then we get 12 in each cases. So, the first ratio 1 is to 3 should be multiple with 1 is to 3 should be multiple with 4. 3, sorry, 3. That results as 3 is to 9. That means A is to B plus C is 3 is to 9. C is to A plus B is 5 is to 7. A is to B is plus C. Here A is represented in the first term, that is A is 3. A is 3. Here C is to A plus B. C is represented in the first term, that is 5. C is 5. A plus B plus C is 12. And A is 3, C is 5, then B equal to 4. Okay, B is 4. We need to find out B is to A plus C. We need to find out B is to A plus C. B is 4 here, and summation of A plus 3, 3 plus 5, that is 8. 4 by 8, that is 4 ones and 4 twos. When we minimize that equation, that ratio gives us 1 by 2. So the required B is to A plus C is 1 by 2. Where is that? Option A. 1 by 2 would be our answer. Next one. A plus B is to B plus C plus A is 4 is to 7 is to 9. And A plus B plus C is 30. Then find C. A plus B is given, B plus C is given, and C plus C A is given in the ratio of 4 is to 7 is to 3. And summation of A, B, C, A plus B plus C is 30. Then we need to find C. When we sum all these three terms, A plus B, B plus C and C plus A, we are going to get, when we sum these three terms, that is A plus B, plus B plus C and this one, that is C plus A, that means 4 plus 7 plus 9. Observe here, there are 2 A's, 2 B's and 2 C's are involving here. That means 2 times of the A plus B plus C is equal to 4 plus 7 plus 9, that is 20. 2 ones and 2 tens. That means A plus B plus C is equal to 10. A plus B plus C is 10. But here, A plus B plus C is given by 30. When we assume the A plus B, B plus C and C plus V A, according to the given values, the A plus B plus C is 10. But the actual value of the A plus B plus C is 30. That is 3 times of the what we assumed. 3 times of what we assumed. That means to get the actual values, we need to multiply any fraction, any term of this ratio 3 times to get the original value. We need to find C. The summation of A plus B plus C is 10. And A plus B here is indicating 4. A plus B is 4. That means when we got the C, when we required the C, the A plus B is 4 and C would be 6 to get the summation 10. C would be 6. But we need to increase that 6 by 3 times to get the actual values. 6 with 3, that is 18. 18 would be our answer. That is option D. 18 would be our answer. Very easy one. Let me explain you once again. But we are not going to write all these A plus B, B plus C again. Here, observe here, A plus B, B plus C and C plus A are given. When the summation of these three variables results as 2 times of the A, 2 times of the B and 2 times of the C. 2 times of the A plus B plus C is 4 plus 7 plus 9, that is 20. 2 ones and 2 tens, that results as A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C is 10. The value we have assumed is 10. The value according to the ratio is 10, but the actual value of the A plus B plus C is given by 30. That means the actual value is 3 times of what we assumed. To get C, we need to subtract A and B from A plus B plus C. When we subtract this A plus B from the A plus B plus C, we get C. According to the ratio, A plus B is 4. A plus B is 4. A plus B is 4. So C would be 6. That gives us the summation of 10. C is 6. According to the assumed value, C is 6. But the actual value would be 3 times of the. Actual value would be the 3 times of the assumed value. That is 18. That is 18. The value of C, what we require is 18. Option D, 18 is our correct answer. Here we have a similar type of question. What just we have solved. A plus B is to B plus C is to C plus A. That is 6 is to 7 is to 8. And A plus B plus C is 14. Then find C. A plus B is given as 6, B plus C is given as 7 and C plus C A is given as 8. We have already known that A plus B plus C would be, A plus B plus B C would be half of the summation of these three values. Why? Why the half of the summation of these three values? when we add these three things, we get 2 times of the A, 2 times of the B, and 2 times of the C. That is 2 times of the A plus B plus C as 21. That is 6 plus 7 plus 8, 21. To get A plus B plus C, we again write that is 21 by 2. So after knowing all these things, we don't need to write 2 steps. Directly write A plus B plus C as 6 plus 7, that is 13 plus 8, 21 by 2. A plus B plus C is 21 by 2. The value taken according to the ratio is 21 by 2, but the actual value of the A plus B plus C is 14. The actual value of the A plus B plus C is 14. The actual value is 4 by 3 times of the what we assumed. 14 is 4 by 3 times of the 4 by 3 times of the value according to the ratio, that is 21 by 2. 3 ones and 3 sevens, 2 ones and 2 twos, that is 14. So the actual value of the according to the question would be 4 by 3 times of the value according to the ratio. Here A plus B plus C is 21 by 2 or 10.5. No matter how we write it, 10.5. We need to find C again. We need to find C again. A plus B plus C is 21 by 2 or 10.5. To get C, subtract the value of A plus B from A plus B plus C. When we subtract A plus B from A plus B plus C, we get C. The value according to the ratio A plus B is 6. The value of A plus B according to the ratio is 6. When we subtract that 6 from the A plus B plus C, we are going to get C is 4.5 or 9 by 2. Subtract 6 from 21 by 2, that gives us 9 by 2. 9 by 2. That is what I have written here. 9 by 2. But the correct answer would be 4 by 3 times of the value according to the ratio. 9 by 2 is the value according to the ratio, but the correct answer would be 4 by 3 times of the value according to the ratio. 3 ones and 3 threes, 2 ones and 2 twos, that is 6. The correct value of C is 6. C is 6. Where is that option? B. C, 6 would be our answer. This is the very best and very easy method to solve these type of questions. Next one. A by 2 equal to B by 3 equal to C by 4. Then find A is to B is to C. Observe here a pattern here. Observe a pattern here. We are going to use this pattern anywhere. Very easy question. When you got the ratio like this, A by 2 equal to B by 3 equal to C by 4, then the ratio of ABC, A is to B is to C, would be 2 is to 3 is to 4. Nothing but the ratio of those given denominators, 2 is to 3 is to 4. Where is that? 2 is to 3 is to 4, B. But why? Let me explain you why we have written like that. A by 2 is equal to B by 3 is equal to C by 4. This is what we are given. Compare with another thing that is equal to all these things, that is K. Now, A by 2 equal to K, B by 3 is equal to K, and C by 4 is equal to K. If you write A value, that is 2 times of the K, and B value 3 times of the K, and the C value is 4 times of the K, we need to find the ratio between A is to B is to C, that is 2K is to 3K is to 4K. Cancel all this case, then we get 2 is to 3 is to 4. This is what we are given, that is A by 2 is equal to B by 3 is equal to C by 4. Then the required ratio of A is to B is to would be ratio of those given denominators. To get that answer, we don't need to write all these things. So after observing all these things, we can conclude easily that when it is given in the form of A by 2 is equal to B by 3 is equal to C by 4, the ratio of A is to B is to C would be the ratio of those given denominators, that is 2 is to 3 is to 4. Very simple thing, 2 is to 3 is to 4. Where is that option B? If you are given like that, A by X is equal to B by Y is equal to C by Z, then the ratio of A is to B is to C is nothing but X is to Y is to Z. Just the ratio of the given denominators, X is to Y is to Z. Or X by 1 is equal to Y by 3 is equal to Z by 7, then the ratio between X is to Y is to Z would be 1 is to 3 is to 7. 1 is to 3 is to 7. Very easy thing. Observe the pattern and remember the answers. Just the ratio of the given denominators would be our answer. That is 2 is to 3 is to 4. This is another pattern of the ratio. This is another pattern we need to remember. We need to observe. once again. Here 6 times of A is equal to 4 times of B is equal to 9 times of C. 6 times of A, 4 times of B and 9 times of C all are equal to each other. To get the A is to B is to C, first of all method 1. Let me explain you the method 1. In this method, we are going to take the LCM or the common multiple of all these things 6, 4 and 9. The LCM of 6, 4 and 9 would be 36. LCM of 6, 4 and 9 would be 36. 36. To get the A is to B is to C, divide that 36 with 6. To get B, divide that 36 with the multiple of coefficient of B, that is 4. To get C, divide that 36 with the coefficient of C, that is 9. 6 ones and 6 6, 4 ones and 4 9s, and 9 ones and 9 4s. 6 is to 9 is to 4 would be the A is to B is to C. That is what we required. This is the method 1 according to the LCM method. But to get A is to B is to C, we can easily conclude that A is to B is to C would be the, when we need to write A, when we need to write A, leave the coefficient of A and take the other two coefficients of B and C respectively. When we need to write the A, leave the coefficient of A and take the coefficients of B and C, the 4 and 9, write the multiplication of those two coefficients of B and C, 4 into 9, that is 36. When we need to write B, just leave aside the coefficient of B and take the other two coefficients of A and C respectively, that is 6 and 9. Write the multiplication of 6 and 9, that is 54. When we need C, leave aside the coefficient of C and take the coefficients of A and B and multiply them to get 24. 6 times of the 4, that is 24. That is 24. When we reduce these ratio into the lowest terms, 6, 6, 6 9s and 6 times 4. That is 6 is to 9 is to 4. These are the two methods. When we are given 6A is equal to 4B equal to 9C and we need to find out A is to B is to C. These are the two methods which helps us to get the final value very easily. First method is LCM method. Take the LCM of those three coefficients of A and B and C. 6, 4, 9. The LCM of 6, 4 and 9 would be 36 and divide that LCM with the coefficients of A, coefficient of B and coefficient of C to get the values of A, B, C respectively. Or to get A, multiply, leave aside the coefficient of A and multiply the coefficients of B and C. That means 4 times of the 9, that is 36. A is representing 36. To get the B value, leave aside the coefficient of B and multiply those two remaining values, that is A and C, 6 times of the 9, that is 54. To write the C value, leave aside the coefficient of C and write the multiplication of 6 and 4, that is 24. When we reduce that ratio into lowest terms, that becomes 6 is to 9 is to 4. This is the very easy method to write the ratio of A is to B is to C when those are given in an equal form. 6 times of A is equal to 4 times of B is equal to 9 times of C and we need to find A is to B is to C, that is 6 is to 9 is to 4. If we take another example, 2 times of A is equal to 3 times of B is equal to 4 times of C. We need to find A is to B is to C. A is to B is to C. To get the A value, leave aside the coefficient of A and multiply the other two coefficients of B and C respectively, that is 3 into 4, that is 12. To write the B value, leave aside the coefficient of B and multiply the remaining two coefficients, that is 2 into 4, that is 8. To get the C, leave aside the 4 and multiply those two remaining, that is 2 into 3, that is 6. To make the ratio into minimal terms, cancel it out with 2, that is 6, 4, 3. 6 is to 4 is to 3. 6 is to 4 is to 3 would be the A is to B is to C. Or you can take the LCM of 2, 3, 4. Or you can take LCM method. Or you can take LCM method. The LCM of 2, 3 and 4 is nothing but 12. To get the A, divide that LCM 12 with the coefficient of A, that is 2. To get the B term, divide that LCM with the coefficient of B, that is 3. And to get the C value, divide that LCM with the coefficient of C, that is 4. 2 1s and 2 6, 3 1s and 3 4s, 4 1s and 4 3s, that is 6 is to 4 is to 3. 6 is to 4 is to 3. I can recommend this one. I would like to recommend this one to get the correct value easily and within seconds. A is to B is to C. Just the multiplication of the coefficients of the other two. Okay. Next one. If A is to B equal to 3 is to 2, then 5A plus 2B is to 3A plus 4B is equal to. Here A is to B is given by 3 is to 2 and we need to find the ratio between 5A plus 2B and 3A plus 4B. Just take the value of A as 3 and the value of B as 2. That is what we required. We don't need to think of anything else. Just take A as 3, just take A as 3 and B as 2. A by B is equal to 3 by 2. That means A is representing 3 and B is representing 3, 2. Just take it as it granted. A is 3 and B is 2. 5A plus 2B. 5 times of the A is 3 and 5 times of the A is, that is 15, plus 2 times of the B is 2 and 2 times of 2, that is 4. 15 plus 4, that is 19 is 2. 3A is 3. 3 times of the 3 is 9 and 4B, B is 2. 4 times of the 2 is 8. 8 plus 9 is 17. 19 is to 17 is the correct required answer. Where is that? Option C. 19 is to 17. Here we have a next question. And observe carefully. From this question, we are going to solve these type of questions. And this is very good mechanism. You need to understand the mechanism how we are so going to solve these ratio methods. Two numbers are in the ratio 2 is to 3. If 10 is added to both the numbers, then the ratio would be 4 is to 5. Then find the numbers, the sum of the numbers, the difference between the numbers, and the product of the numbers. Traditionally, we solve the equations to get the answers. But in competitive examinations, we don't have that much of time in solving those traditional equations and getting the answers. We need to find some mechanisms to solve them very easily with some quick time, within some quick time. To do that, how we are going to deal with this? Two numbers are in the ratio 2 is to 3. When 10 is added both the numbers to the both numbers, the ratio becomes 4 is to 5. Observe here, two numbers are in the ratio 2 is to 3, but the ratio would become 4 is to 5, but the ratio becomes 4 is to 5 when 10 is added to both the numbers. Just observe a pattern here. The first term 2 becomes 4, that means it is increased by 2, and the ratio second term, that is 3, becomes 5, that means it is increased by 2 also. The gap of the two ratios is the gap between the two antecedents in the ratio and the two precedents in the two consequents in the ratio are uniform, that is 2. We have added 10 in both the cases. That means that 2, That increased value 2 is nothing but 10. That is what we added to the both the numbers. 10 is added to both the numbers. That means when we add the 10 to the first term, it becomes 4. And when you add to the 10 to the second term, it becomes 5. Here the gap is same. That gap 2 becomes 10. That means every value of the ratio becomes 5 times. 2 becomes 10. That means 5 times. To get the correct answers, we need to increase any value 5 times to get the correct values of the answers. The numbers, to get that numbers, increase that ratio by 5 times. First, to get the first number, increase that 2 by 5 times, that is 10. To get the second number, increase that 3 by 5 times, that is 15. Those numbers are 10 and 15 respectively. The sum of the numbers, to get the sum of the numbers, when we know the numbers separately, we can add them. 10 plus 15, that is 25, or from the ratio itself we can conclude the numbers as 2 and 3. The numbers are represented by 2 and 3 in the ratio. 2 and 3, that is 5. But to get the actual answers, we need to multiply anything with 5, that is 25. The difference between the numbers according to ratio is 1. But to get the correct answer, we need to multiply that 1 with 5. Anything with 5. anything with 5. That is 5. The difference between those two numbers is 5. But here observe carefully. The product of the numbers. The product of the numbers. We know the numbers separately, that is 10 and 15. That gives us 150 is the product of the numbers. But according to ratio, when we draw the answer according to the ratio, product of 2 and 3 is 6. But here we need to multiply those numbers by 5 square. But why? To get the first number, we multiply that 2 with 5. And to get the second number, we multiply that 3 with 5. To get the product of the numbers, 2 into 5 into 3 into 5. Here, 2 into 3 is in the multiplication with 5 square. So, observe carefully, when we need the product of the numbers, we need to multiply that 6 with 5 square. That means 6 times of the 25, that is 150. 6 times of the 25, that is 150. These are the answers we need to find out. Here the gap is same, so our mechanism would be very easy. But when the gap is not uniform, what to do? Let's discuss in the next question. Two numbers are in the ratio 3:2. If 15 is added to both the numbers, then the ratio becomes 9:7. Find the numbers. Same type of questions that we have solved just now. Here, 3:2. Two numbers are in the ratio 3:2. But 15 is added to both the numbers, that becomes 9:7. Observe here gap is not same. The gap between 3 and 9 is 6, and the gap between 2 and 7 is 5. But the number which we have added to both terms is same, that is 15. But here the gap is not same. Then what to do? What to do in these type of situations? No problem. Any situation, just one solution. That means we have added that 15 in both the cases. We have added that 15 in both the cases. We have added 15 to the precedent term of 3 to get the precedent term of the 9 in the consequent ratio, and 15 to the second term to get the second term as 7. Observe a mechanism here. Take the multiplication of these two numbers, 3 times the 7, that is 21. Take a multiplication of these two, 9 twos, that is 18. Take the difference between them. Take a multiplication of 3 and 7, that is 21, and 9 and 2, take a difference between them, that is 3. And then take the multiplication between these two crosses. Take the multiplication of 9 times of the 15, that is 135. And take the multiplication of 7 times of the 15, that is 105. Take the difference between them, that is 30. Compare these three with this 13, that is 10 times. The actual value would be 10 times of the value according to the ratio. To get those numbers, we need to multiply those ratios with 10. First number would be 10 times of the 3, that is 30. Second number would be 10 times of the 2, that is 20. 30 and 20 are the numbers we need to find out. Just check the number, whether the answer is correct or not. We have the numbers, the actual numbers 30 and 20. When we added 15 to the both the cases, when we added 15 to the first number, that becomes 45. When we added 15 to the second number, that is 35. That means 5 nines and 5 sevens. The ratio becomes 9:7 when 15 is added to both the cases. We don't need to solve the traditional equations to get these numbers. This is the best method to solve these type of questions. Let me explain you once again. Very easy. The ratio of two numbers is 3:2, and the ratio becomes 9:7 when we added 15 to both the numbers. Take the multiplication of these two, that is 3 into 7, that is 21, and these two, that is 9 into 2, that is 18. Take the difference between them, that is 3. Compare that 3 with the difference between the multiplication of these two. 9 into 15, that is 135, and 7 into 15, that is 105. Then compare 3 with 30. 9 into 15, that is 135, and 7 into 15 is 105. The difference between 135 and 105 is 30. 3 is 30. 3 when 3 becomes 30, that means 3 is increased by 10 times. So, to get the actual values, we need to multiply any number with 10, any number in the ratio with 10 to get the actual values. 3 times of the 10, that is 30, 2 into 10, that is 20. 30 and 20 are the numbers. Okay, this is the best method to solve these type of sums. Next one, two numbers are in the ratio 3 is to 4. If 12 is added to the first and 4 is added to the second, then the ratio would be 3 is to 2. Find the numbers. Observe here. Observe a beautiful scenarios here. First, in the first question here, the gap is same. The gap is same. In the second question, the gap is not same. But we added the same number to the both the numbers. But here, we did not add the same numbers here. The first ratio that is given by is the ratio between two numbers is 3 is to 4 and the ratio would be 3 is to 2 and the ratio would be 3 is to 2 when we add 12 to the first number and 4 to the second number. When we add 12 to the first number and 4 to the second number, then the ratio would be 3 is to 2. Observe here, the ratio 3 and 3 are same here. Even after adding 12, the ratio becomes 3 here. We don't need to be hasty in any manner. Just imply what we have implied in the last question. Same solution for any question. Take the multiplication of 3 and 2, that is 6. Take the multiplication of 3 and 4, that is 12. The difference between 6 and 12 is 6. Take the multiplication of 4 and 3, that is 12. Take the multiplication of 12 and 2, that is 24. Take the difference between those two. 3 times of the 4, that is 12, and 2 times of the 12, that is 24. Take the difference between those, that is 12. Compare this difference 6 with the difference 12. That means when 6 becomes 12, that means 2 times. Then to get the actual numbers, we need to multiply the terms 3 and 4, the terms 3 and 4 with 2. That is 3 times 2, so 6, 4, 2, sorry. These are the two numbers. Let's check once. The actual numbers are 6 and 8. When we add 12 to the first number, it becomes 18. When we add 4 to the second number, it becomes 12. 6 to 3 and 6 to 2, that is 3 is to 2. The ratio becomes 3 is to 2. That is what we are given with 3 is to 2. Okay. I hope you understand this method. And let me explain you once again and in a quick time. The ratio is nothing but 3 is to 2 and the ratio becomes 3 is to 4, the ratio, they becomes 3 is to 2 when we add 12 to the first number and 4 to the second number. Take the difference between the product of these two crosses. 3 to 6, 3 4 are 12, that difference is 6. Compare that 6 with the product of these ones. That is 3 4 are 12 and 12 2 are 24. The difference between 12 and 24 is 12. When 6 becomes 12, that means 2 times, we need to multiply all these numbers with 2, get the actual numbers. 3 2s are 6 and 4 2s are 8. These are the numbers we need to find out. 6 and 8. This is the best mechanism to solve these type of questions. 6 and 8 are the required numbers. Next one. Two numbers are in the ratio 4 is to 3. If 4 is added to the first and 5 is subtracted from the second, then the ratio becomes 4 is to 5. Find the numbers. Observe here. 4 is added to the first number and 5 is subtracted from the second number. Okay, don't worry, we are going to do the same thing again here. When the numbers are in the ratio 4 is to 3, the ratio becomes 4 is to 1. When 4 is added to the first number and 5 is subtracted from the second number, find the numbers. Apply the same mechanism once again here. 4 1s is 4 and 4 3s are 12. The difference between 4 and 12 is 8. Compare that 8 with. Take the multiplication of 4 and 5, that is minus 20. Take the multiplication of 4 and 1, that is 4. The difference between minus 20 and 4 is 24. The difference between minus 20 and 4 is 24. The difference between minus 20 and 4. On the number line, the difference between minus 20 and 4 is 24. Okay. Compare that 8 with 24. That becomes 3 times. When it is becoming 3 times, we need to make all these things 3 times to get the actual answers. 4 3s are 12 and 3 3s are 9. That means the correct answers would be 12 and 9. The correct answers would be 12 and 9. Very easily we have solved these questions. No problem. What is given in the question, we are going to solve with the same approach. Don't need to go to the another approach. With this approach we can solve any question. Here you can observe here what we have done. We have employed the same method in every case to get the answers quickly, as early as possible. Here we have another question. Two numbers are in the ratio 4:9. If both the numbers increased by 12, then the ratio becomes 11:21. The sum of the original numbers is, two numbers are in the ratio 4:9. Two numbers are in the ratio 4:9. When both the numbers is increased by 12, the ratio becomes 11:21. 11:21. 11:21. When the 11:21, when we added 12 to the both the numbers. Imply the same mechanism once again here. 21 into 4, that is 84. And 9 into 11, 99. The difference between 84 and 99 is 15. Compare with 15, that 15 with the difference between the product of these two and these two. 11 into 12 and the 12 into 21, that means 120. The difference between those two is 120. 15 ones and 15 eights. It is 8 times. To get the actual numbers, so, but we need to find the sum of the original numbers. The sum of these numbers, these two, is according to the ratio, the summation is 4 plus 9 is 13. But we need to multiply with 8 to get the actual answer. 13 times of the 8, that is 104. 104 would be our correct answer. That is option 4. Option D, 104 would be the correct answer. We have employed the same mechanism in every way to get the answers quickly. We don't need to find out any others. Okay. We have solved some basic, we have learned what is ratio. And we have solved some basic questions in this video. And I have discussed about some mechanisms that are going to be very useful in our future classes. And I hope you enjoyed this session and you have learned something new and something unique in this video. And let's meet in the another video. And please subscribe the channel and like the video, share to the friends and hit the bell icon to get the instant notifications. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel to get the instant notifications. Okay, thank you.